Within the emerging markets of the world today, there are promising areas of opportunity for industrial and commercial investment. And one such place is Emnambithi Ladysmith in KwaZulu-Natal, South Africa. A recent retail study has shown the town and its surrounds to be one of the biggest growth points in the province. It is an investment gem that lies almost halfway between South Africa's key domestic markets of Gauteng and the busiest port on the African continent, Durban. It is served by an impressive infrastructure of rail, road and air transport, as excellent water and electricity resources. A first world infrastructure, a dependable and reliable municipality, available skilled and unskilled labour, and large tracts of land waiting for development. Investors are offered the choice of a number of new sites in stands varying from 2,000 to 8,000 square meters in four serviced industrial parks: Kalenzo, Ezakeni, Danskraal, and Emnambithi, that all enjoy a high standard of cooperation and support from an active business partner municipality that will assist with rezoning and EIA applications. Among the major national and international industrial players that have found conditions conducive enough to anchor in the town are Dunlop, trading as Apollo Tires, manufacturers of high-performance steel radial passenger vehicle tires, an international company with strong and historic links to the country's transport industry. DeFi, manufacturers of domestic appliances. Zorbitex Textiles, manufacturers from cotton yarn to finished product of domestic textiles, such as towels and baby nappies. Lasher Tools, manufacturers of tools and garden implements, among other products. Boardman Brothers, manufacturers of paint, candles and polishes. And Canvas and Tent, largest supplier of canvas and PVC products to the South African Defence Force, as well as being a preferred supplier to the United Nations and the British Army for military tents. Several other well-known companies have also chosen to locate distribution depots in the light industrial area of Emnambithi. One of the biggest investment opportunities lies in the industrial park known as Extension 15, which lies strategically between two arterial roads, the N11 and the P32, and which has development plans over a period of 25 years that include space for a large shopping mall, a housing estate, warehouses and factories. The municipality's integrated transport plan has made provision for the present and future transport requirements. Ladysmith is a major railway junction linking the town with Durban and Gauteng, as well as the Free State and Lesotho. A logistical study has been done to develop the railways as a transport hub for containers and goods, integrating the nearby Nzenga as a container dry port with Durban Harbour and the interior. An additional spur in this regard is the proposed $30 billion Chinese-funded high-speed rail link between Johannesburg and Durban, with Ladysmith as a strategic economic hub in the middle. Ladysmith is served by an excellent road infrastructure, linking to the N3 freeway, which connects the town with markets throughout the country and beyond, and the N11, linking the town with surrounding centres and communities in northern KwaZulu-Natal, making Ladysmith a strategic development corridor. The local taxi industry plays a vital role in providing cost-effective transport to the thousands of workers and residents in the greater municipal area. In order to accommodate their expanding activities is a new taxi rank, providing for the needs of both commuters and taxi personnel. For those wishing to get somewhere in a hurry, there's a busy and expanding aerodrome handling small fixed-wing aircraft and helicopters. This is one of three licensed aerodromes in northern KwaZulu-Natal and is strongly supported by business and tourism. Ladysmith has a perennial water supply from the Klip River, which winds its way through the town. And together with the Tugela River that flows through Kalenzo, the water needs of the four industrial parks is ensured. A reliable power supply from Eskom is available, backed up during peak periods by the recently developed conservation-friendly and sustainable Ingula pump storage system, consisting of an upper and a lower reservoir. Harnessing the power of water from the mighty Uchaklamba-Drakensberg range. The region is rich in natural resources such as coal, with many mines in the outskirts of surrounding towns. The town has an available labour force with a reliable work ethic living in housing developments close to industrial parks. Good relationships exist among the labour force, the informal traders association, the local chamber of commerce and industry, and the Department of Labour. Compared with other areas in South Africa, residents in Ladysmith enjoy a relatively crime-free environment. Streets in the town's central hub are monitored on a daily basis with cameras placed at strategic points to keep a close eye on daily activities and report on unusual incidents that could need further investigation. Fire engines and trained personnel are on standby to handle any emergency at a moment's notice. It is a town which has excellent social services and a municipality that cares for its people. Every month, 234 residents from the different sectors of the municipal area who communities have singled out to be in need of help are given large food parcels in exchange for keeping the streets of their sector clean. Fresh produce is supplied from surrounding farms in the area which specialize in beef farming. The town offers the best of both worlds, with the peace and tranquility of the countryside infused in its beautiful suburbs, set away from the hustle and bustle of a vibrant commercial centre. A large conservancy and country club form an integral part of the residential area that overlooks the town, offering residents a lifestyle experience on their doorstep that few enjoy in the big cities. The town's popularity as a sought-after place to live and work is evident from the many new quality homes springing up in the new suburbs. Emnambithi Ladysmith has the largest population in the greater Utukela district municipality. They are served by 52 councillors representing 27 wards. As a third tier of government, where there exists a close interface with the people it serves, the municipality's five-year comprehensive integrated development plan acts as a principal plan in guiding the town towards a prosperous future for all its people. There is a marked absence of slums and large-scale squatter camps in the outlying regions of the town. The clean streets and well-constructed homes in the outlying areas all have access to the available municipal services. From its earliest years, the townsfolk have been conscious of their spiritual needs and built many inspiring houses of worship, several of which have interesting historic links. The stained glass windows depicting war and peace and the memorial tablets inside this Anglican church honour the 3,000 British soldiers and civilians who died in defence of Ladysmith during the siege of the town in 1900. Supported by the Muslim community, this beautiful Sufi mosque was a labour of love of one man who built it over a number of years. Flourishing modern retail outlets in large shopping malls offer everything from basic provisions to luxury goods. And for that out of the ordinary item, the speciality mall is the place to visit. Private and provincial hospitals served by highly trained doctors, dentists and other medical specialists cater for the needs of residents and visitors. As an educational centre of excellence, Ladysmith has a number of fine public and private schools, all located in the residential areas of the communities they serve. Recognized FET institutions also making a contribution towards the training of skilled individuals making their way into the job market. Yet, it's not all work and no play, because the town offers facilities for all the popular sporting codes. Aya. As a tourist or visitor doing business in the town, there are many accommodation options to choose. From historic hotels such as the Royal and Crown, to a host of upmarket B&Bs. People entering the town by road are reminded that this is the hometown of the world-famous Grammy Award-winning Ladysmith Black Mambazo. Joseph Shabalala and his talented group have put Zulu traditional music on the world music map. When in town, and not touring the national and international circuit, they can be found at this historic building, the Emnambithi Ladysmith Cultural Centre in the CBD. Ladysmith is steeped in history. As a small town at the turn of the century, it received international attention when the Boers laid siege to it for 118 days at the beginning of the Anglo-Boer War. The relieving British forces under Sir Redvers Buller only managed to break through the Boer line of defence after four attempts. The final assault was through the Tugela Heights, following a significant victory on Peter's Hill, and the town was finally relieved. But the most memorable battle, also the bloodiest, took place on Spionkop in January 1900. On this mountain, during and immediately after the battle, were three men who were later to leave their mark in history. Winston Churchill witnessed the aftermath of the battle and stood among the war dead on the so-called Acre of Massacre. Mahatma Gandhi was a stretcher bearer who helped take the British wounded off the hill to the field hospital. And finally, Louis Botha, leader of the Boer forces, who later became the first Prime Minister of the Union of South Africa. A memorial to the Boers who were killed during the various battles in and around the town is located on Wagon Hill above the aerodrome. Below the Burger Memorial is a plaque and graves commemorating some of the British soldiers who perished during the siege of Ladysmith. For an overview of the siege, this museum next to the historic town hall gives the visitor a clear perspective of what happened, when and where. It also captures the period in this impressive display of photographs, rifles, uniforms and costumes. Ladysmith is the gateway to the central and northern Uchaklamba Drakensberg World Heritage Site, renowned for its breathtaking beauty, scenic splendor and world-renowned sand bushman rock art. For the visitor, there are numerous resorts and plenty of leisure time activities to choose from in this magnificent mountain setting. As a significant region in Africa, Ladysmith is not without its wildlife. Just on the outskirts of town is the Nambithi Private Game Reserve, which hosts the big five, as well as a number of other species. This is Wild Africa on the town's doorstep. A reserve minus the carnivores is to be found on the other side of town. The Spionkop Nature Reserve is a place to chill out and find harmony with nature and its less aggressive wildlife species. Hiking trails and water sports are available for the active visitor. Ladysmith's vision is to be KwaZulu-Natal's vibrant industrial, commercial, trade and tourism interlink, where its residents enjoy a prosperous, caring, safe and secure environment that promotes cultural diversity and a high-quality lifestyle. It's a town with much to offer and annual events that bring out the crowds. Councillor DCP Mazibuko welcomes you, the investor, to this wonderful town, where people who take up residence here stay put for many years to come.
As the mayor of Ladysmith, I want to take this opportunity to welcome the investors in Ladysmith. Ladysmith is a home of Ladysmith Black Mambazo. We want to say to all of you, you are welcome in Ladysmith. Feel at home. We want to make sure that at the end of the day, we provide our communities with jobs.
Yeah.